Good morning, good morning, good morning, you guys. How are you on this great Thursday? It is a little cooler, but it is still kind of warm, and I'm grateful. Today, I am coming from my book, Prayers That Prevail for the Children, for your children. Prayers That Prevail for Your Children, a parent's and grandparent's manual of prayers. Father God, I ask you to keep all of us parents, guardians, strengthened in this day of time. Help us to know what it is that these children, our children, need, their wants, their complications that they're having in their lives, where they may not want to speak about it, and the ones who are openly to speak about it, we will know the ways to help to teach them. So Father God, I thank you for giving me the opportunity to be a parent of six and more as you bring them my way. I thank you for all the parents that are doing what it is that you call them to do. I believe that it is our gift. In Jesus' name, amen. Biblical goals for parents. Biblical goals for parents. A parent's greatest resource. Being a parent in today's society is an awesome responsibility. Yes, it is. It requires more skill and perseverance than any other role in life. Parenting is truly a ministry of eternal proportions. The parenting, it's a lot for us parents out there that's doing what we're supposed to do as parents. It's a lot. It requires more skills than any other role in life. Parenting is truly a ministry. You guys hear that? Of eternal proportions. It is our ministry, your first ministry. Just as your family is your first ministry, come on, y'all kids are. Though it is hard work, parenting is immensely rewarding. It is a creative endeavor that involves the shaping and molding of a precious life. In this process, we become laborers together with God. You can go to 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 9. Who is vitally concerned about the welfare of our children? We cannot become what parents should be without his help. We cannot become what parents should be without his help. Thank you, Lord. As parents, we must learn to say with Paul, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthen me. And that is Philippians chapter 4, 13. Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. Jesus said, I am the vine. We are the branches. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit, for without me ye can do nothing. That is John chapter 15, verse 5. John chapter 15, verse 5. It is this exciting truth that every parent must recall and act on daily. God has been so good to us as our loving Heavenly Father. He has made certain that all our needs have been supplied. In fact, He promises this to us in no uncertain words. But my God shall supply all your need according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus. You can find that in the book of Philippians, chapter 4, Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. As we learn to appreciate God's promises into our scarred calling as parents, our faith is built up and our children are blessed. As in all things, Jesus has paved the way for us. He said, "I will pray the Father, and He shall give you another Comforter," thank you, Holy Spirit, "that He may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth Him not, neither knoweth Him. But ye know Him, for He dwelt with you and shall be in you." That is in John chapter 14, verses 16 and 17. John chapter 14, verses 16 and 17. Every parent who understands and receives the truth of these words of Jesus has learned the secret of effective parenting. That secret is found as we open our hearts and our lives to the power and wisdom and the truth of God's Holy Spirit. We are not alone. He dwells with us and He lives within us. This is a parent greatest resource, the power of God's Spirit who inhabits each believer's heart. The fruit of the Spirit's indwelling is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. You can find that in Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23, which is exhaling in God's arms foundation. That is Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 and 23. The parent who bears such fruit in his or her dealings with his or her children is an effective parent. The child of such a parent reaches out to take the fruit of the Spirit for himself, to taste and see that the Lord is good. And that is Psalms 34, 8. Psalms chapter 34, verse 8. Through personal prayer, a daily quiet time, a parent draws close to Jesus, the vine of life. Workers in vineyards prune the branches of grapevines very close to the main vine in order to make them more fruitful. The closer we get to Jesus, through His word, prayer, and the presence of the Holy Spirit, the more fruitful we become in our parenting and in all the responsibilities and relationships of our lives. Through prayer, we learn how to abide in Him and to let His words abide in us. The result of such abiding is answered prayer. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. John chapter 15, verse 7. John chapter 15, verse 7. Believing activates this promise in behalf of our children as we learn to abide in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. By praying the Word of God, by using the topical prayers and prayers that prevail for your children, We become like the man described in Psalms 1. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, the word of God, and in his law doeth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Praying the word of God enables us to meditate upon his truth, his principles, his precepts. It gives us wisdom in living and in parenting. God promises that when we pray this way, he will give us stability. He will become like trees. We will become like trees planted on the rivers of water. These are healthy, strong trees that are never affected by floods, storms, or winds. That's why I love palm trees, which my name means palm tree. They stand fast and impart a sense of constancy and to their environment. Parents with such stability give peace and security to their children. Parents with such ability give peace and security to their children. The individual who meditates upon God's word day and night will become fruitful in all his doings as well. I hope this word help someone today. I'm going to continue to read from this book, in my Holy Spirit book, throughout the month of March. It's a must, because our children, they need guidance. We need guidance from the Holy Ghost to guide these children. We cannot do this alone. With all this stuff that's coming upon our children, I have learned when we are trying to save our children, there's so much out here that are trying to harm our children. I just learned that these vapors that they are using, they are now looking like USBs. Which our children need for a schooling, especially our junior and high school kids. They use USB. And now they are making these in a form that look just like USB. You thinking it's their homework assignments, that's why they're carrying them. No. These things they are inhaling, they are vapors. I also learned that there are over 15,500 in counting fluids that they can put inside these for them to inhale to damage their lungs. Come on, y'all. So we must, as parents and guardians, pray, be examples in front of our children. Pray, because we cannot go hard on them, hard in the paint, for some of us may say. If we doing this in front of them and we get, I'm trying to use my word, bang on them when they start doing it. Yes, they are minors, and we have to express that. We are grown, and we have to express that. But You know how these kids are now today and even back in our day? Well, you did it, so why can't I? Why can't I? And then some of the parents, you know, oh, I let my kid do this and that. They at home, they can do it. No, don't do that. You can do what you want to do, but it's not healthy, man. It is not healthy. You encouraging them to do things that they shouldn't be doing, that's not going to get them ahead, that's going to stunt their growth. Y'all adults are grown. These kids are growing. So if they smoking weed, drinking, doing all these things with the parents, and the parents know that they are and not trying to stop them from doing it, go figure. That messes with their brain. Their brain are not finished developing. Their bodies are not finished developing. So don't blame them if you're encouraging them to do things that's damaging their mental, physical, and spiritual. I thank you guys for tuning in this morning, and I pray that your day will continue, your days will continue to be blessed in Jesus' name. God bless you all.